Myself Vaibhav. In today's session of Visual JForex, I will be explaining to you the use of indicator named Force Index. This is an indicator we can use to utilize the place the trades with the trend, and also we can consider its momentum. And when we see that the momentum is also being backed by good enough volume, we can decide to go for the trade. So this indicator is going to be quite helpful when we are looking at all the factors, the trend, the strength of the trend, as well as the volume behind the move. So all these factors taken together are of course going to increase the profitability, the probability of profit, if not certainty. So we now go back to the JForex platform. Here I have added this indicator with the default configuration, Force Index with the 13 as its default candle period, and this is the 4-hourly time frame. The chart is of USD JPY. The idea is going to be fairly simple. We want to be trading with the trend. So what we will do is we will use its classical use technique. The value should be above zero for any buy trade to be executed, and the value of last 4 hours should be below the zero for any sell trade to be executed. We will be relying on this configuration, and as this indicator is an unbound indicator, meaning it has no predefined preset lower value or the upper value, so we will not be going into its absolute values. Instead of that, we will take the multiples of it. What we need is to make sure that the momentum is on our side, and to make sure, we will rely on the force index property that whenever there is sudden spurt in the price action, there is a force indicator, force index value jumps multifold, and that is what we are going to use. We want last 4-hourly candle period's force index output to be at least more than twice when we are going for a buy trade, and when we are going for a sell trade, we want last 4 hours force index output to be less than twice of the penultimate 4-hourly candle force index output, and that is going to be the basic requirement. And then we turn our attention to the lower time frame charting of the hourly time frame, and here if the 4-hourly conditions are in place, we want the last hourly force index output value to be more than at least 5 times of the penultimate hour's force index output value for any buy trade. And if the 4-hourly conditions are favorable for any shorting opportunity, then we want the last hour's force index output value to be less than at least 5 times of the output value of the force index for the penultimate hour. So that is going to be our basic configuration requirement. And this gives us the trades whenever we see significant momentum building up in the underlying instrument. So we will be avoiding the trades when there is not much momentum, when the momentum is sideways, when the price action is sideways, and that is going to be the reason why we are using the multiple of these output values. So now let us go to the Visual JForex board, which has been developed by the Dukascopy Bank SA. And as we do most of the time, we will start with the instrument subscription first. And for that, we are going to need the logical components, e-blocks. E-blocks to define the instrument subscription and the position amount. On candle will be the start point for this session. Okay. Default variable, default instrument should match the candle instrument. And candle instrument should match the instrument of choice, which is going to be USD JPY. We are going to work with the USD JPY as our favorite instrument for this session. So in this listing, we have to find it. Okay, here it is. I will need to change this one also. Okay, I got it. So I have changed the default instrument to USD JPY, and then this instrument of choice is also USD JPY. Okay. After that, the position amount, position info, all position, position amount should be equal to 0. That means no trade order will be placed unless there is a zero position on the account, zero existing position. There should not be any existing open or the pending order in the system. And after that, we are going to bring in the indicator block. Oscillator just below the Euler-Fisher transform, which we had considered in the last session. Now, coming to the configuration of this block, we have to define these five input parameters depending on which we will get this output. And the default instrument is USD JPY, so no need to change, but the candle period will need to be changed to 4 hours. The shift will be 1, and the MA type is going to be SMA. Okay, on the chart also we are relying on these same combination SMA. The time period is 13. This is going to help us retrieve the data for the last 4 hours output of the force index, and we also have to consider the penultimate 4 hour candles output. So we need one more force index block with the same configuration. The only difference is going to be shift value, the loopback rate. Okay, I will change this to 4 hours, and the shift will be changed to 2. Let me type SMA. This will help us in getting the data for 4 hourly candle blocks. Now we also have to look at the configuration of the hourly candle periods, and for that two more force index blocks will be needed. So the period will be 1 and 2. Every type SMA. Okay, now moving to the get historical candle, we will need the info blocks. logical This will need to be changed. The candle period will need to be changed to hourly. We will use this last hour's price action to see whether we should be going in for the trade or not. We will consider its closing and opening levels, and also we will take a certain percentage of the difference between the opening and the closing level to place the order, as we will not be going in for a market open. So this get historical candle block of the hourly time frame will be providing a lot of info at the execution point. Shift is going to be 1. And then to pinpoint the exact entry point, if you have been a regular viewer, you might be well aware. I take these 2 more candle blocks, get historical candles of 10 second stage with the shift of 1 and 2 respectively. So one more will be needed now. This will also be changed to 10 seconds, and the look back period will be changed to 2. So these are the basic building blocks for our algorithm. Using this, we will be considering the force index as well as the price action, and we will configure the setup in such a way that the probability of the trade going in for good enough profit should be higher, and that should be our purpose whenever we are designing any algorithm. So that's it for today's session. Here we will be stopping, and in next session we will be looking at the price action and defining certain requirements using the calculation expressions. And once we are done with that, we will also be placing the final conditions for execution of the trade, and most probably we will be able to complete the buy side in next session. And in subsequent session, then the focus will shift to the sell side of the equation. So that's it for the day. Thank you all for joining in. Do subscribe to the Dukascopy webinar channel to stay updated on market developments. See you next time. Till then, goodbye.